You're watching Global National.
The Luka Magnotta murder trial heard from two surprising witnesses today, the son of a former prime minister and the sister of a notorious killer. Mike LeCouture shows us their connection to the case and the stunning information that was revealed. Mike?
Well, Robin, the name Carla Homolka hasn't been uttered in this city in quite some time. So you can imagine how surprising it was when her sister was called to testify today at the trial of Luka Magnotta.
In the hours after killing Jun Lin, Magnotta wasted little time getting rid of the evidence, mailing several body parts around the country. In addition to sending appendages to the Conservative Party in Ottawa, he sent another to a Vancouver school. The return address? Logan Valentini. Years ago, she changed her name from Lori Homolka. Testifying by video conference, the sister of serial killer Carla Homolka was clearly surprised and frustrated to once again be connected to a murder. I was kind of stunned. Didn't know why I'd be dragged into something again that had nothing to do with me. Now, also dragged into this story, Hubert Chrétien, the son of former Prime Minister Jean Chrétien. His name was also used as a return address.
I don't think it's going to help the defense. I think it's going to hurt the defense.
Criminal lawyer Eric Sutton believes this kind of evidence makes it difficult for Magnotta's lawyers to argue he's not criminally responsible by reason of mental disorder.
He's trying to really steer the police in a different direction other than his direction. And that could suggest to a jury that he knows exactly what he's done and he knows it's wrong.
That wasn't the only stunner at the trial today. When asked if she had been in contact with her famous sister, Homolka said she had been and that the serial killer is once again living in Quebec. Robin.
Mike LeCouture in Montreal. Thanks very much, Mike.